सैटेलाइट वायरसेस, सैटेलाइट आरएनए एंड वायराइड्स. सो एज लाइक ऑफ फंगई, बैक्टीरिया एंड वायरसेस, दीज आर आल्सो अ टाइप ऑफ प्लांट पैथोजेंस दैट कैन इन्फेक्ट प्लांट्स. So now we will see what are all the general characters, properties, and you know applications of these components. So my name is N. H. Shankar Reddy, and I am doing PhD Plant Pathology in Annamalai University. Satellite viruses. So the first satellite virus was reported as tobacco necrosis satellite virus. Tobacco necrosis satellite virus that is associated with the tobacco necrosis virus. So it was discovered by Cassanis. So the first satellite virus is tobacco necrosis satellite virus. Tobacco necrosis satellite virus was the first satellite virus that was actually associated with the tobacco necrosis virus, which was first reported by Cassanis. It's a very important question that may be asked in national eligibility test. So the satellite virus was discovered by Cassanis. Like this, they will ask. And what is the first satellite virus? Tobacco necrosis satellite virus is the first satellite virus. So coming to the definition, so this satellite virus is a subviral agents which is composed of as like of you know nucleic acid and protein as like of viruses. So the but main difference between plant viruses and satellite viruses are, so the satellite viruses, due to the lack of necessary genes, they can't able to replicate themselves. So further, they have to dependent on another virus, that is helper virus, for replication, multiplication and co-infection. So simply, satellite viruses are the subviral agents which is composed of nucleic acid and protein coat, but they don't have the necessary genes for replication and multiplication. Further, they have to dependent on another virus. That another virus is called helper virus. So the satellite viruses have to dependent on another viruses for replication. That is called helper virus. So with the help of helper virus only, the satellite virus can replicate, multiplicate and co-infect, because they lack necessary genes for these mechanisms, that is replication, multiplication and infection. Though here the satellite virus genome is composed of a single stranded RNA or DNA or circular RNA. So and they are actually replicated by the enzymes which are provided or produced by the helper virus. That's what I'm telling. So they need some genes for replication and another mechanisms. So with the help of helper virus enzymes, or the enzymes which is produced by the helper virus, that can be used by the satellite virus for replication, multiplication and co-infection. So the here the genome of satellite virus is composed of RNA or DNA, RNA or DNA, that is single stranded RNA or DNA, or circular RNA, or circular RNA. We can see here diagram, it's a circular RNA like component or particle. So here, and are replicated by the enzymes which are provided by the helper virus that I'm telling. So they lack necessary genes, so that they can't able to multiply or replicate by themselves or by their own. So that they use the enzymes of helper virus for the replication. So the best example is tobacco necrosis satellite virus. It is the first satellite virus to be discovered by Cassanis. So satellite virus was discovered by Cassanis. As I said that satellite tobacco necrosis virus or tobacco necrosis satellite virus was the first discovered or recognized plant virus, where the size ranges from 17 nanometer isomeric particles, whereas the tobacco necrosis virus, which size ranges from 30 nanometer. So they will ask this type of questions only. Let me tell you. So tobacco necrosis satellite virus, the size is 17 nanometer. It is the smallest. And tobacco necrosis virus, which is 30 nanometer. This type of questions only they will ask. 30 nanometer. So the coming to the properties. So the nucleic acid size is very small, that is 0.2 to 1.5 kilo base pairs, which shares the no sequence homology with the helper virus for replication. And again, the same point they're going to repeat, that the nucleic acid sequence do not share any homology with the helper virus. Let us consider it will get the information from the helper virus, that is the enzymes from the helper virus, but it never share any sequence homology or the any information of satellite virus. So it will get the information from someone else, but it don't share any information to helper viruses or any other viruses. So they are dependent on helper virus for replication. As I told you earlier, they need a helper virus or another virus for replication and infection. And they code their own protein, so they can multiplicate their own code protein, or they can code their own code protein. So here they interferes with the replication of helper virus. It's like a parasite here. So they are getting the information or the necessary requirements like enzymes, whatever the helper virus, whatever the satellite virus required for their replication and infection. But and the thing that we have to observe here is, after having the enzymes from helper virus, it interfering with the replication of helper virus. Let us consider virus 1 is satellite virus, virus 2 is helper virus. Let us consider it is producing some enzymes, it is producing some enzymes that was used by satellite virus. So due to the enzymes which is used by satellite virus, helper virus enzymes which is used by the satellite virus, so that the helper virus can't able to replicate, that interferes the satellite virus, which interferes with the replication of helper virus because it is using the enzymes of helper virus. So it's like a parasitism that's happened. Sometimes it never interferes with the replication of helper virus, but most of the times it interferes with the replication of helper virus. The satellite virus which use the enzymes of helper virus, and sometimes it interferes with the replication of helper virus. So the satellite RNA may increases or decrease the severity of virus infection dependence on the maybe type of enzymes or maybe host environmental conditions, and it may increase or decrease the severity of viral infection. Sometimes it may be decrease the severity of viral infection, or sometimes the satellite virus may be increase the severity of viral infection. These are all the properties. Then the next one is satellite RNA. So satellite RNA are small linear or circular RNAs, and circular RNA, it's not you can't say it's a pathogen, but it's a strand, like it is a nucleotide strand that we can say. So the satellite RNA is a small linear or circular RNA strand found in the virions of a certain multi-component virus. In the sense, virions in the cells, a complete or matured virus particles is called virions. Matured virus particles are called virions. So this strands or satellite RNA strands are, these are small linear circular RNA strands which are found in the virions, are completely matured or developed virus particles is called virions. The important thing is they do not code their own code protein. They do not multiply their own code protein, or they do not code their own code protein, and are dependent on helper virus as like of satellite. They are dependent on helper virus for both replication and as well as encapsulation as like of satellite virus. So here there are three types of satellite RNA has been discovered so far. The first one is large satellite RNA or B type, small linear satellite RNA C type, small circular satellite RNA D type. So far there are three types of satellite RNA has been discovered, that is large satellite RNA or B type, small linear satellite RNA or C type, or small circular satellite RNA, that is D type. On the right side we can see the diagrammatic representation here. This is the satellite RNA, a particular component. Again, so this RNA, satellite RNA is a small linear circular RNA component which is mostly observed in the multi-component of virion particles, that is completely developed virus particles called virion. So these are observed in virions. So they do not code any code protein as like of a satellite virus. It also required another helper virus for replication and as well as encapsulation. So there are three types of satellite virus has been discovered so far, that is large satellite RNA B type, small linear satellite RNA C type, small circular satellite RNA D type. Now what are the application? Now we'll see the application of satellite RNA. So the mild strains of helper virus containing satellite virus, mild strains in the sense strains which can cause less damage or less infection in plants is considered as mild strains. So the mild strains of helper virus which contains satellite RNA to fields can protect the plants from severe strains. Let us consider if the mild strains contains a satellite RNA. So with the help of the satellite RNA mild strains, we can protect the plants from the severe strains. It's a little bit of cross production, but we can't say it's a cross production because the technique of cross production is entirely different. That we will discuss it in later slides, sorry, later PowerPoint presentations. So with the satellite RNA, what we are doing, so the satellite RNA, if it is there in the mild strains, or if we can insert with the help of a genetic engineering techniques, so that it can protect the field crops from severe strains of plant viruses. So the producing transgenic plants that express the satellite RNA sequences, due to that, you know, due to the production of the satellite RNA sequences, we can, you know, we can achieve, or we can protect the plant viruses, from severe strains of plant viruses or other types of plant viruses. So the development of satellite RNA based vector system for the expression of foreign genes on plants, so that what will happen here, so that if the RNA based vector system, if we developed in, you know, for expressing the foreign genes on plants, that will be very helpful, so that the vectors can't able to inject the plant virus, even though it inject the plant viruses, that can't able to cause the infection. So these are the applications of satellite RNA based system. So now we will see the advantages. So the satellite RNA is easy for manipulation, as well as high in vivo stability, that is laboratory stability, and high expression level. So it expresses at a high range, so that the expression range is very high, in vivo stability, as well as multiplication is also very easy. So coming to viroids. So the viroids were first discovered by Diener in the year of 1971. So the viroids were first discovered by Diener. He's a scientist which was he was working in USDA, United States of Department of Agriculture, as IRS, Agriculture Research Scientist in USDA. So in those times of 1960s and 1970s onwards, he was working on some type of plant pathogens that have, you know, that produce not uniform potatoes. So he started working on it, and then he discovered that this was caused by a special type or new type of a plant pathogen, that is viroid. So viroid was first discovered by Diener in the year of 1971. So the first viroid discovered is potato spindle tuber viroid, is the first viroid to be discovered by Diener. So the viroids were first discovered by Diener in the year of 1971. So the viroids, coming to the definition, so viroids are small RNA molecules. So viroid genome only contains RNA. There is no DNA viroids has been discovered so far. So all the viroids whose genome is composed of RNA molecule, that is single-stranded RNA molecule, all viroids genome is composed of RNA molecule only. The size ranges from 246 to 401 nucleotide length. So the size is 246 to 401 nucleotide length, which are having the secondary structures. So it's not much consideration. Then we'll come to the sixth one, very, very important. They do not code their protein sequences, very, very important. They do not code their protein sequences. One more important thing that we have to consider here, virus contains protein coat and nucleic acid, whereas viroids do not contains protein coat. That's why it's called as devoid of protein coat. Give an example of pathogen with devoid of protein coat, that is viroid. Viroid is devoid of protein. Devoid in the sense it doesn't contains any protein coat, it only contains nucleic acid. So that is the main difference between plant viruses and as well as viroids. So here they replicate independently using the host polymerase. By using the enzyme host polymerase, they can replicate individually or independently. So the well-studied viroids are potato spindle tuber viroid. This is the first viroid to be discovered by Diener, I told you earlier. And then Avogadro sunblotch viroid or Hopstront viroid, these are the most well-studied viroids so far. So the name viroids are abbreviated with VD. D in the sense, let us consider virus ends with V, as viroids ends with VD, not actually D, it's a wrong one, VD. We have to place it as VD. So the viroids are always abbreviated with VD in the sense viroid. Coming to symptoms, viroids can infect both monocots and as well as dicots. So we'll see the symptoms. So here the symptoms are more or less similar to those of viruses. More or less similar to the viruses like stunting, modeling, leaf distortion. Sometimes symptoms like you know, Hopf's latent viroid, that this viroid won't produce any symptoms. That is called a latent infection. So what will happen here? Inside the plant cells or plasma membranes, you know, plasma membrane shows corrugations, thickness, or cell wall abnormalities in the chloroplast can be observed as a symptoms of plant virus. Sorry, viroids. So one more thing, the viroids can only infect plants. It don't have a mechanism, or so far there is no virus has been so viroid has been discovered that infect animals. The two things that we have to remember about plant viroids are viroids can only infect plant. Viroid's genome contains RNA only, single stranded RNA. So far there is no DNA viroid has been discovered. So viroids contains RNA as a genetic material. Coming to the properties of viroids, so as I told you earlier, the viroid size ranges from 246 to 401 nucleotides. So they are circular RNA molecule, while it's a rod-like in viroids belonging to PosP viridae. There is two groups of viroids can be seen, that is PosP viridae as well as Avicenna viridae, PosP viridae. These are the two groups of viroids. So almost all plant viroids, so far there are 40 viroids has been discovered that infect plants. So these all 40 viroids are almost only two groups are there in the viroids, that is PosP viridae and Avicenna viridae. PosP viridae and Avicenna viridae. So on the basis of the sequence analysis or secondary predictions, following domain has been recognized in potato spindle tuber viroid. Then now coming to, so far as I told you that 40 viroid disease has been reported that caused the disease in plants. There are so far 40 viroid disease has been reported in the world. So the viroid moves from cell to cell through plasmodesmata and cell division, as like of a plant viruses. The viroid also moves from cell to cell through plasmodesmata only, cell to cell through plasmodesmata, and it can also move through cell divisions. So while dividing the plant cells or the host cells, it can divide along with the cell division so that you can infect or it can spread from one cell to another cell. So the replication mechanism of viroids is rolling circle mechanism. So the replication mechanism of viroids is rolling circle mechanism, is the replication mechanism viroids. So the enzyme used for the viroids replication is RNA polymerase 2, whereas RNA polymerase 1 is the enzyme used for the replication of plant viruses. But here the enzyme required for the replication of viroids is RNA polymerase 2. RNA polymerase 1 is meant for virus replication, whereas RNA polymerase 2 is meant for viroid replication. As I told you, the symptoms ranges from severe development of disorders like, as you know, leaf chlorosis, necrosis, stunting, flower alterations, and fruit and seed deformations are the different types of symptoms that we can observe due to viroids. So the best example is potato spindle tuber viroid is the first viroid to be discovered, and then coconut kadankadan viroid. Then we will see the main differences between PosP viridae and Avicenna viridae. As I told you that the only two groups of viroids has been there is PosP viridae and Avicenna viridae. So the shape of a molecule, is circular in PosP viridae. And again, it's the same as like of a circular in Avicenna viridae. The secondary structures are rod-like, as well as in Avicenna viridae, it's a branch. Central conserved region, that is CCR, central conserved region, is present in PosP viridae. Very, very, very important. Central conserved region or CCR present in PosP viridae, whereas the CCR is absent in Avicenna viridae. So central conserved region or CCR is present in PosP viridae, whereas it is absent in Avicenna viridae. The site of replication of PosP viroids are nucleus. Whereas site of replication of Avicenna viridae are chloroplast. So site of replication is chloroplast, whereas site of replication of PosP viridae is nucleus, whereas chloroplast is the site of replication for Avicenna viridae. So the coming to the mechanism of replication, rolling circle asymmetrical replication mechanism can be observed in PosP viridae, and the rolling circle symmetrical mechanism can be observed in Avicenna viridae. So the main two things that we have to observe here is CCR is present in PosP viridae. CCR is absent in Avicenna viridae, that is CCR in the sense central conserved region, whereas the mechanism of replication is asymmetrical type, asymmetrical type is Pospiviridae. Symmetrical type is Avicenniviridae. Whereas site of replication of Pospiviridates happens in the in nucleus, whereas Avicenniviridates happens in the in chloroplast. Here the host enzyme is nuclear DNA dependent RNA polymerase. So the enzyme required for the Pospiviridate replication or the enzyme required is DNA dependent RNA polymerase. Nuclear in the sense because it is replicating in the nucleus. That's why they mentioned is a nuclear. That's it. Okay, then you can come to here, the DNA dependent RNA polymerase is the enzyme required for replication. In the sense of here, so DNA dependent RNA polymerase is required for Avicenniviridae, that is chloroplast. Here the main is nuclear DNA dependent, whereas here chloroplast DNA dependent RNA polymerase. Then cleavage of a replication product is host nuclease RNA, that is hammerhead ribosomes. There are some cleavage replication product or product that is produced by the Pospiviridae and as well as Avicenniviridae. Coming to replication mechanism of virides, here replication mechanism is asymmetrical and symmetrical. Two types are here we can see. So asymmetrical that represent for Avicenniviridae, sorry Pospiviridae, whereas symmetrical represent for Avicenniviridae. So I don't want to study all those things, that let me tell you in a simple way. So the Pospiviridae asymmetrical pathway, we can see here the strand will be asymmetrically replicated here, and then you can see native strand, oligomeric strands, and again then cleavated into sites and host range. Then the replication will happen and the new virid can be produced here. That is the replication mechanism of Pospiviridae. And coming to the replication mechanism of Avicenniviridae, we can see here cleavated with the hammerhead ribosome. We can see here this is a ribosome which cleaves like this hammerhead ribosome. The final product that they are seen already in differences. So and then again as like of a Pospiviridae, then monomeric negative strands will happen. Again there is some extra circular thing, that is extra linear multimeric component can be seen here. This is plus strand again that will cleaved as like a hammerhead ribosome, as like of here that is a Pospiviridae we can see here. And then again the viroid particle can be formed. So don't get confused with this, that I will definitely do one more video for on replication of virids, so that it will be very easy to understand. So this is about satellite viruses, satellite RNA, and as well as virids.